All right, so we're going to take the brakes off of gear motors here. I already took this side off just to see how easy it was, but I'll show you this one. So there's just a tie that will open it. Take off this rubber guard. There's the brake. So there's a couple 3mm socket head screws there. Just take off all four and that was it. There you go, this comes off. I'll feed the wire out from the harness. There's a lock nut with a set screw on there. Not sure if I'm gonna take that off or not. Don't think it's gonna interfere with anything else. It just sits in that, I don't know if you can see that, sits in that spot right there, right? So, should be fine. All right, so just pull off the clamps here. Or the twist ties, sorry. Zip ties. Expose the wires. Snip them out there. Alright, so the first bench test, got our controller, our transmitter, sorry. We have the two motors set up with 24 volt in series and in parallel, just because they're small. The 32 dual saber tooth with the receiver. Let's give it a little test here. All right, so if I go forward, they both go. If I go right, left, that one goes forward, this one goes backwards, and right, this one goes backwards, that one goes forward. So far it seems like there's a lot of torque. Not sure what speed's going to be like, but I'd rather the torque. Just gonna go through it now. Do a bench test here. I just have a jumble of wires here, but so they're series parallel. We've got battery coming in, motor one, motor two, and on the other side. I got the servo wires going to channel 1, channel 2 on the receiver, and going into signal 1, signal 2. So I figured I'd show you the dip switches here. Got this little pad there, Sabertooth comes with this. There's analog, radio, serial, or USB. And you set your dip switches according to this. So I have mine as the off-on, and then I have battery instead of the power supply. I have mixed mode, which is the differential drive. And then exponential is, it's less responsive at lower speeds, makes it easier to handle. I'll try it out. I'm not sure how that's gonna work, but. So we got off, on, off, on, off, on. You just flick these left or right, little tool. Neat little controller. Dimensional Engineering has a massive printout that you can get all the information, you know, about this and the software, and you can quite a lot of customizability here. I'm not gonna mess around too much as long as it works. We'll get into that stuff another time. Put a link down to this in the description. Pretty useful. It's worth the read. Alright, so that's pretty much it for the parts. Start building something out of this stuff.